All right, welcome back. Welcome back, everybody. It was slow December. I felt the need to be with you guys, and I'm so glad we started again so we can see you all and chit chat over whatever need to be talked about. Okay, so I hope everybody stayed safe, and I'm sure you did because you're here, but continue to remain safe because and if you do get sick, don't worry about it. There is a whole sort of procedure to be done. Don't get scared. Don't let the fear get hold of you so that stops you from doing stuff that you can normally do. But make sure you are following all the health rules, okay? All right, with that, let's sit at the edge of the chair. Make sure you're sitting on your sit bone, which we may have forgotten we have because of all the weight gain throughout December. Make sure your knees are over your ankles, straight line, back is nice and straight. Put your arms on the side. Take a deep breath in, inhale, up, 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 inhale. Deep inhale and exhale slowly out, 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 out. Make sure you're using your nose to inhale, and you can use your mouth to exhale or your nose, okay? Now somebody asked me about the breaths, pranayama. Basically, the breaths are what it is all about, and we normally do the breaths, and I want you to understand that when you breathe in through your nose, through your nostrils in, make sure you're expanding your lungs, filling it up with air like a balloon, so much so that it presses down onto your stomach. The stomach feels like it's enlarged, and then when you exhale slowly out, your belly goes to spine, you exhale out and everything goes out. So the breath should be like this. Remember, a balloon. Inhale and exhale. Okay? All right. Oh, I almost forget something. Okay, hands to heart. Take a deep breath in, inhale, inhale, up, 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 as far up as you can go. Inhale, keep inhaling, and slowly exhale, push, push down, and exhale through your nose or through your mouth, slow exhale, right down. Make sure you're reaching out, inhale, up, inhale, inhale, up, 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 palms together, exhale, palms out, exhale, slowly out, 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 reach out, reach out. Right down towards your legs. Inhale again. Scoop it all up. Beautiful energy. Inhale. Exhale. Palms out. Exhale. Out, 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 out. Slowly down. One more time. Inhale. Up, 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 up. Bring your palms together. And exhale slowly as you bring your palms back to your chest. Slowly down to your chest. Okay? Inhale one more time. Inhale. Deep inhale. Exhale. Palms forward and come down. Back straight. Chin forward. Chest forward. Bring your arms right towards your back. As far as you can go. Inhale. 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 Palms together. And exhale. Slowly up. Down, 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 down. And all the way up. Inhale again, scoop it up, 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 up. Exhale slowly down. Let's do a circle with your palms pressing towards each other. Inhale up. Exhale down. Try and do a full circle. Breathe, breathe. Inhale, exhale. Breaths are what pranayama is. Okay, the different kinds of breaths. And we are always doing the inhale, hold, exhale. So that's one way. There is alternate nostril breathing. There is one with the belly breathing. Different types of breaths, but it's all about breaths. Breaths is life. Slowly inhale, exhale. One more time. Totally round and bring it up on towards your head. Bring it on your, touch your head. Inhale, exhale up. Down, inhale up, exhale back there, inhale up, and touch your the top of your head. Inhale, exhale. Bring your arms down, right, straight, and give yourself a nice little hug. Make sure your arms are going as far back as you can, touch your shoulders. Inhale, lift your elbows up. Inhale, exhale down. Inhale up, exhale down, open out. Inhale nice and wide. This time, the opposite side hug. So the other arm comes on top. Inhale, bring it up, exhale down. Inhale up, exhale down. Inhale up, exhale down, open out. And bring it back to your side and let's do a circle. Inhale up, exhale down. Slow movements, inhale, exhale. Just gonna loosen up all those joints that have been not used and is not mine throughout December. Slow movements up and down. Slow movements, inhale, exhale. No hurry, it's like you're rowing a boat. Inhale, exhale, make sure you're breathing. Big breaths in, slow exhale. Inhale, exhale, we're gonna change other way around now. Go back, inhale, exhale. Inhale, exhale, smile. Exhale, smile again. And forward, inhale, exhale, forward, inhale. And bring your arms together. And slowly bring them back to your heart center. Very good. I wanted to play this particular track because that was for you, Navy, actually, really, because I know you love the song and it means a lot and it brings a lot of peace because we are asking for grace of the Lord to be with us. So that was for you, Navy. We are with you too, okay? Put your hands on your thighs. And take a deep breath in, inhale, bring your shoulders up, inhale, exhale, slowly down, circle, inhale, up, exhale, slowly down, inhale, up, bring it as far up near your ears as possible. So let's loosen up all those joints, the stiffness that comes with the weather and with the whatever we don't do all the time. Inhale, exhale, and now let's do it the other way around. Inhale and exhale. Inhale, exhale. Inhale up, exhale down. Slow movements, very shoulder movements. Very good. Last one. And now bring your one side of your head towards your shoulder. Don't force it, just do what you can. Back is straight, shoulders are straight. They are not moving. It's my head that's coming down. And it won't go far, of course, right? But whatever you can do, you can't force it. This side, and then bring it back to center. Let's do the other side. And you may notice that one side is much more flexible than the other. And that's the way the body is. One side is always stronger than the other. And bring it up. One more time. Inhale. Exhale. Other way. Exhale. Now we're gonna go up. Look up and feel the stretched shoulders are again still straight. Back is straight, nothing else is moving. I'm gonna just bring my chin up. And when I go up, I open my mouth. Ah, nice and wide. Feel all the tension, the pressure in your cheekbones, your jaw bones, everywhere. Ah, and then close your jaw and then come back down. One more time, inhale, go up, open your mouth. Nice and wide, ah, and maybe stick your tongue out this time, ah. And then bring it back down slowly. And let's do a little bit of a head roll, okay? So look up, inhale, exhale down. Just my head's moving and my neck. Nothing else is moving, nice and soft. Every other part of your body is not tense, it's nice and soft. Don't put tension on anything else. And do what you can. If your head rolls are giving you issues, don't do them or just do light movements. And let's do the other side. Inhale, And breathing is very important all the time. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, last one, and back. This time, you're gonna bring one shoulder up, doesn't matter which one, bring it up, and you're gonna tilt your head to that shoulder. Tilt your head to that shoulder, okay, and the opposite arm goes out, okay, and take it as far back as you can. And let's do a roll with those arms while your head is down. Slow movements, don't jerk, just slow, and then do it the other way while my head is tilted. And don't force it, just do what you can. And then bring it back down and back to your thigh. Lift your head up and bring your shoulder down. Okay? Now let's do the other side. So I'm gonna first bring my shoulder up as far as I can, and then go with my head, tilt my head towards the shoulder. Don't force it. And the other arm goes out, opposite arm goes out. Feel the nice stretch in your upper shoulder area. And then let's do a little bit of a roll. One, inhale, exhale, last one. And then you're gonna do it opposite way. One, two, and three. And bring it back, on back to your thighs, and slowly lift your head up. And let's do a circle roll again with your shoulders. And last one, bring it forward and back. Great, super. And shake it all up. Shake, 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 shake. Shake your toes and your heels, bang on your heels. Yeah, feel that pressure there. And move your arms around, cross them. Feel the nice, easy freedom. Lots of freedom we have lost from outside, but we don't want to be locked inside. We want to be free inside. We cannot be outside right now for whatever reasons that we have to be safe, but we cannot lock ourselves from inside. So be free to express, feel all the emotions that you're feeling. Let it go, okay? You can call your friend, you can talk to somebody. It is a trying time because it's depressing. And a lot of mental issues are happening. A lot of our family members are getting sick, which is happening a lot. But we cannot live in fear. We need to fight this by being strong internally as well as body-wise. And the only way to do internally is to do a lot of meditation, yoga, calmness, all that mindfulness. And to be strong, of course, the body needs to be healthy, right? To eat well, be strong. And I forgot to print that article that I'm sure a lot of people saw, that little attachment that Zuleika sent out about make your body your life partner. Who is your life partner? Yeah, we have life partners, but at the end of the day, when the body starts to talk back to you with different things, that is, you are the only one that can take care of it. That is your life partner. It's going to be there till you die. So take care of it and remind yourself to take care of it. That was a beautiful thing. I hope you read it, and if you haven't, you should. Okay, it was in your emails. Okay, arms up again, inhale. Exhale, nice and soft. Bring one arm to your chest, one arm to your tummy. Okay, I want you to feel those breaths. Feel those breaths rise and fall. Okay, so when you breathe in, it's rise. Your chest is rising because your lungs are expanding. Your tummy is rising because the lungs are pushing your tummy. And when you exhale, you'll feel the fall of your chest as well as your tummy. All right? So let's fill up the air first. Go right into your... So you let your tummy rise first. So because the air is going in. And actually, mentally try and feel that your tummy is rising first. Then your chest. And then when you exhale, we're going to do tummy first and then the chest. So these are two movements that are going on, tummy, the stomach, as well as the heart, as you breathe in and out. It requires focus, but see if you can do it. So one arm on your chest, one arm on your belly, okay? Now when you breathe in, inhale, feel your tummy rise, and then your chest, fill it up. And then when you exhale, exhale from your tummy first, exhale, and then your chest. So it's alternate, totally out. Inhale again, feel your tummy first, inhale, then your chest, Exhale, slowly exhale from your tummy first. Let your tummy go down and then your chest. It requires focus and it can be done. So let's do one more time. Inhale, breathe in, long breath. And right, tummy's up, tummy's rising, chest rising. And then exhale, tummy out, down, go tummy, belly to spine. And chest goes back. So let's do one more time. Inhale, now this time we're gonna move our arms out, okay? So inhale. Arms out. Hold your breath for a count of 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Exhale slowly, tummy, chest. Opposite arm comes on top. So you're doing three different things now. Trying to remember the belly, spine, as well as your chest and movement of your heart, a movement of your hands, as well as your breath. Okay, see what you can do. Inhale, nice and wide. Exhale, opposite. Inhale, nice and wide. Exhale, opposite. One more time, inhale, nice and wide, as far as you can go. Exhale, opposite. Very good. And then shake it all out. Bring your arms, palms up. Toes, bring your arms, your fingers pointing up. And just slide your legs a little bit out towards, out on in front of you. And then go on your heels. Okay, go on your heels. So your toes are up. And your fingers are up. And then you're gonna go down and your toes are gonna go down. So you're on your toes. So your heels and toes and fingers are going up and down. Inhale, exhale, inhale, exhale, smile, inhale, exhale. Very good. Couple more. Very good. Now let's do a little bit of a wrist as well as ankles. So sit comfortable if you're sitting and bring your both your legs up, okay? And let's do a little bit of a rotation. Hold your tummy tight while you're doing this. So your core tight, back is not leaning down there like that. Okay, I want you to, if you can help it, bring yourself straight up, spine straight. It doesn't have to be stiff, but just upper. Don't use the chair, unless if you need to, okay? If you need to, no problem. Let's do a rotation of your ankles and your wrists. Excellent. Very good. Now the other way. Inhale, exhale. And you're breathing all the time. Make sure breath, deep breaths, not shallow breaths. And one more time, one side. And this time, we're gonna bring our base of your palm together and your heels together. Tummy tight. Inhale. And then you're gonna do toes come together, fingers come together. Toes and fingers. Toes and fingers. Yeah, there you go. Let's do a rotation. So what's happening is you're rotating your shoulders as well as your heel, your hips. Okay, so it's important that all the joints are being used and there's mobility there. And the only way to do the mobility is to use them. Okay, very good. And then bring them down. Okay, shake it out, shake it out, shake it out. Bring yourself to the edge of the chair, a little bit more towards the edge. One leg slides over as far as you can. One leg is just near your ankle. The other one is slided forward, but the whole foot is on the ground and you're holding onto the chair at the back. Okay, and you're sitting, still sitting. And as you go out, as far as you can, then raise your toes up and feel that nice stretch in your calf muscles in the back of your leg here. Okay, feel it, nice, inhale, look up, exhale, look back if you can. Very good. And then bring your foot down, back flat on the ground. One more time, bring it up and look up and down. Very good. And then bring it back to center. Let's slide the other foot out as far as you can, flat on the ground. When you can't go any more forward, you're gonna bring your toes up, you're on your heels, and you can feel that nice stretch in the back of your leg. And look up, inhale, and exhale. Inhale again, Exhale down. Inhale one more time. Exhale down. And then bring your legs back to center. Adjust yourself to the center now. We're gonna go do a little bit of forward folds. So inhale, arms up, nice and tall. Exhale, forward, come forward, back is straight, look forward. And go back as far as you can. Inhale, up. This time, you're gonna go touch your knees and then roll yourself down, 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 down. Roll yourself back to your knees. And down, 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 down. As far as you can go. Up again to your knees. This time you're gonna go down. Hold on to the floor or to your legs with both your arms, wherever you can touch. If you can't, you can just go like this. This is good enough. Wherever you can touch, okay? Adjust yourself, make sure you are grounded. And then we're gonna raise your one arm up. Inhale, look up, stay there. And bring it down again. Inhale, bring your arm, other arm up, look up, and exhale down. One more time, inhale up, exhale down, inhale up, exhale down. Now walk, while you're down, just walk to one side of your chair, or if you're standing, just one side, and then to the other side. Very good, and then come back center. Go under your chair as far as you can and bring your arms up and down. Very good, and shake it up. Inhale up, bring to cactus. Cactus, as I told you before, is shoulder and elbow are same height, okay? And if you cannot bring it right to that level, this is good enough. But try and stay here and between this range. Okay, not like this. It's okay to go like this too. That's another movement. But let's do cactus right now. Okay, so your hands are up, nice and tall. Look forward, smile, smile. Okay, now we're gonna do something with our arms. So we're gonna inhale and twist to one side as far as you can go and then back to center. Other side, twist, 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 twist and back to center. One more time, twist, 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 and back to center. Other side, twist, 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 as far as you can go, center. And this time you're gonna come forward, but the arms are not, they're also coming forward, but they're not moving from that angle, okay? So inhale, exhale like you're falling, exhale, look forward, chest forward, chin forward, and right here, inhale, up. Exhale down, right, soft movements. Breathe through this, please. And last one, and there you go. Inhale up, okay? And now we're gonna do one arm down and one arm up. One arm down, one arm up. See if you can remain your arm that's up, the length stays the same, and this too. So the shoulder and elbow hopefully are in the same range. Okay, even a little bit up and down is okay. Like I said, one side may be better than the other. Very good, and bring both your arms up. This time, we're gonna put one arm on the on your knee and the other arm is up. Nice and tall, as far as you can go, and then bend towards the other side. See if you can reach there as far as you can. And bring it up again. Bring it down. Do the other arm. Go up as far as you can go. Take it up and then bend down as far as you can. Feel that nice stretch on your waist area. Breathe in. And bring it up. And bring it down again. And let's do a shoulder again. Just to release some pressure. Just gonna do some head movements with the eyes, okay? Remember, eyes are very important part of our being. Without eyes, it's very difficult to function. So basically, we need to exercise the muscles under your eyeballs there. So what we do is we look around and that's what we need to do, because you also trigger the tears in that way, so that it remains moist. Especially in this weather, when it's dry and everything, your eyes start to itch. So make sure that you are doing that lot of blinking a lot of eye movements. Okay, so let's do that. So bring your arms back to your knees or thighs. We're gonna turn our head first. Take a deep breath in. Inhale, back straight, shoulders straight, just my neck, head movements, and my eyes. So inhale. And exhale, just turn your head to one side as far as it can go. And with your eyes, even further. Your eyes can look further from the corner of your eyes. And still, let's stay there and then come back slowly back to center. Other side, go back to the other side. Your head goes out to the side. And with your eyes, try and go as far as you can from the corner of your eyes. Very good. And then come back center. Very good. Now, while you're sitting here, just look up without moving your face or your arms or nothing. Everything is still. The eyes are going to go up. Up, up, and then look down, 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 and look up again. Just with your eye movement, down. Now, look side, from one side. My head is not turning, just my eyes. Side, and then the other side. One side. Then the other side. And then just with your eyes, just go circle. So go up one side, down, other side. Up one side, down, other side. Reverse, up, opposite side, down, side, up, opposite side. Without moving your head, just your eyes are rolling. And then come back center and blink, 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 blink. Blink few times so that they get a rest. Bring your thumbs up, both your thumbs are up, and you're touching with your palms are touching with the thumbs up. Inhale, bring your thumbs out wide as far as you can, and then come back to center, and then let go one arm and just one thumb. Now again, what you're gonna do is you're gonna look at that thumb, and without moving your head, you're not gonna turn your head. It's the eyes that will follow the thumb as far as it can go, until it disappears, the object disappears, and then you bring it back to center with your eyes, okay? Look at your thumb, make sure you're breathing, slow breathes, and keep looking at the thumb without moving your head. Keep looking at your thumb without moving your head. Keep looking, until it disappears. I'm not turning my head, and now in my case, the thumb has disappeared. So I'll bring it back slowly and keep looking at the thumb. Keep looking at the thumb and bring it back to center and bring it down. All right. So important things to do aside from taking other care of your body. But this is important. Hearing is important. Nose is important. Mouth, everything is important. Okay, so bring up your thumb again. Inhale. And without turning my head, I'm going to just look at my thumb. Without turning my head, I'm just looking at the corner of my eye as far as I can go without turning my head. And it disappeared. Now I'm going to bring it back into vision. Without turning my head, I'm looking from the corner of my eye. And bring it back to center. Excellent. And bring it down. Shake it all up. All right. Hands out. Bring it to your shoulders. Out again, and shoulders. Out, back. Let's put our feet out like that. Yeah, good. So we're moving our feet, not just sitting around. And you're doing jumping jack flash, whatever it's called. Smile, very good. And see if you can cross your feet at the same time. Opposite, with opposite foot in the front. Change your foot every time. See if you can do that. Good. And stop there. Now leave your feet again, knee over ankle, and shoulders, your fingers on your shoulders, and bring your elbows together and up as far as you can go. Inhale, exhale, breathe, inhale, bring, chest, open your chest, exhale, squeeze it all up. Inhale, exhale, inhale again, exhale, and circle. See if you can touch your elbows, if possible. And two, three, and four. Now let's do reverse, other way. Make sure you're breathing. Two, three, four, and five. And see if you can bring one elbow down, one elbow up, back to center. One elbow down, one elbow up. See if you can bring your elbows behind your head as much as you can. Feel that nice stretch. Breathe and exhale slowly down. One more time, inhale. Exhale slowly down. Very good, and shake it up, shake it out. Let's do some of the legs now. So come to the edge of the chair, okay? Lift your one leg up, hands are on the side. Okay, so I'm balancing my foot without holding it right now. Just a few inches away on top. So I can feel it in my core. And just hold, breathe, and then just extend your foot and bring it up. Extend. Now, if you need help, you can hold it and do it. It's up to you. You listen to your body and don't feel bad about doing things to help yourself to do something, because that is a natural way to do stuff. You don't want to get hurt. But if you want to just try without holding, that's fine too. Just gives you a little bit of movement, okay? Whole idea is to keep moving and not feeling bad about things in life and about yourselves and what is happening and what is going to happen, and it's going to happen the way it's going to happen, right? Up and extend, down, extend and bring it down. And then just give a little bit of a boost to your thigh here where the joints worked hard. Let's do the other foot. Again, my both arms on the side and I lift up. Now if you need help to lift up, remember, use your arms. Okay, and hold it under your thigh here. And then we can extend and up. Extend and up. And hold it if you need it. Just do a few more. Hold your core tight at the same time. Very good. A couple more. And up and up and out and up and down. Very good. Work yourself out. Work yourselves back in. Work yourselves out. Bring your arms up. Inhale. And bring yourself down, 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 as far as you can go. Touch wherever you can. Inhale up. And then go towards the other foot. Inhale up. And then reverse. And up. And bring it down again. Touch wherever you can. And bring it up. Hands on your knees and bring your, walk your legs back to center. You can do some little bit of a hip and a knee. So edge of the chair, lift up your leg, and let's move to so this one, this part stays steady. It's my hip that's moving. And you can point your toes if you like. And you can hold it if you like. Whatever works for you. All right? If you need help, one side may need more help than the other, that's fine. And just move it so that there is movement in your hip joint here. And if you are doing this, hold your core tight. And now the other way. The other way. Excellent. 2, 3, 4, and 5. Very good. And then just massage, massage. And let's do the same leg, but now you're going to do the knee. So you're going to lift it up. You can hold it under your thigh there to for support. And then just move it one way slowly. And if you don't need to hold, you don't have to. Okay, do what you can. And then the other way. Very good. And you may find that you haven't done this for a whole month, and if you've not been doing other stuff, like following other people or YouTubes or whatever, then it'd be a tough day today. But we're gonna get through it, right? Lift your other foot. Okay, now you're gonna do the hip with this foot. Okay, again, if you need to hold, please hold. But what the idea is to move from your hip joint, all right? And hold your core tight, two more, and reverse. Very good, excellent, very good. And now we just do, put it down for rest, just a little squeeze there. Now do the knee up again, and we rotate through our knee. So what is happening is our knee joints are using some mobility, and yeah, so one, two, you can hold and do it. And the other way. 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Bring it down. Great. Let's do some lower back, and then we'll go to the weights and stuff, okay? All right. Lift up your leg. You can cross your leg, sorry. Cross your leg, and if that's all you can do, just stay here. If you wanna try further up, you can cross, put your knee over knee. Right, we do this all the time. knee over knee, and you can hold on to your knees with both your arms, but the back is straight. Third position, so you can lift it up and bring your ankle on your thigh or shin on your thigh. And again, the back is to be straight. In all three positions, back is straight. In the other first two positions, you're holding onto your knee. In this position, you're holding knee and shin or ankle. And back is nice and straight. This is great for your lower back. My lower back is having issues right now because I wore the wrong slippers. And that gave me almost like a sciatica, which is, I was really found out right away. It was nothing to do with anything but what I was wearing. So be careful. Sometimes back pains and neck pains are related to your feet. How your feet are going up and down on a slipper or on the floor or whatever. So, you know, it's all connected, right? Okay, so bring it there. Hold on. Nice and tall. Big inhale. Then exhale, bring your shoulders forward, chin forward, chest forward. And you'll feel a nice little stretch at the back there. But only do what you can. Don't force into any painful positions. Inhale up, nice and tall. Exhale slowly, chin forward, chest forward. One more time, inhale. Exhale forward, very good, as far as you can go. Back again, bring your arms up, both your arms. Inhale and come forward again. The arms just go parallel to the floor, look forward. Chin forward, chest forward, inhale. Again, you'll feel that nice pull in the back, but it doesn't have to be painful. And you stop when you feel the pain because you don't want pain. Inhale, up. Very good, bring your arms to cactus. Very good, cactus. And let's see if you can do it with a cactus pull. And go down as much as you can and up again, all right? And then you're gonna bring our elbow to elbow. This knee is up, so this elbow will go into the other elbow. So we are crossing. So we're just crossing like this. You can stay here if that's all you can, we want to do or can do. Or you can go, you can see if you can, arms can get the back of the arms together. Stay here if you want. We're gonna try one more time to bring palms to palm. Pigeon pose, baby pigeon pose. So your legs are crossed, your arms are crossed. Up and down, breathe in. Exhale down and see if you wanna come forward a little bit. Just bend a little bit and feel that nice stretch in the back. Just a little bit of a side to side. And then come back center. Bring your arms out and away we go. All right. Inhale up. Palms together. Exhale slowly down. Your chin, that your knee that's up, just bring it to your chest. Give a nice little squeeze. And then bring it out. Okay. And then we're going to do the other foot now. So cross the other foot. Now the other foot is in front. Okay, so you can stay here, like I said before. You can bring it here. You're good to go. Or you can bring it this way. But when, if you're bringing it this way, make sure the foot on the ground is solid down and not up and down, okay? And the knees over ankle. So you can really feel the stretch. Okay, again, back straight. You can be like this and do everything the same way I tell you. But do what you can. Now hold on tight, inhale. Exhale, forward, 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 as far as you can go. And you'll feel it, and then stop if it hurts. And again, inhale. Back straight, exhale, chin forward, chest forward. Slowly, as much as you can. Inhale, up again. Last one, exhale, slowly, smile. Inhale. Okay, and then bring your arms up, nice and tall. Exhale, slowly down again. The arms are parallel to the floor. Inhale, up. Exhale, slowly. Chin forward, chest forward. And only do what you can. This time bring it to cactus. All right, smile. This knee is up, so this elbow will go inside. So it's opposite from what we did. So just cross. And you can stay here. Hanging onto your shoulders, and this is okay. If you want to try further, you can bring your back of your arms together, palms together, so it'll be like this. Or if you want to challenge one more time, bring your palm to palm and your tummy, try and hold your core tight. Inhale up and exhale down. Inhale up, exhale down, and then slowly come forward. as much as you can, and up again, and then go one side, center, other side, center, arms out, and you fly away in the little rain that you're gonna have. And then bring your knees to your chest, hug yourselves, and see if you can bring your head down towards your knee as much as you can. And then up, and then bring it down, and shake it all out. Great, let's grab our straps, our resistance band, or tie, scarf, whatever you have, okay? And sit at the edge of the chair. Okay, edge of the chair, arms out. And see if you can keep stretching, okay? Keep stretching, pulling out with your arms. Okay, inhale, keep pulling out whatever you have in your arms. Just pull out. Inhale, bring your arms up, 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 as far as you can. And then bring it to one side, pull from with the lower arm, and then bring it up again. And the other side, as far as you can. Inhale, one more time, one side, and back again. Pull, 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 very good. And this time bring it forward. My back is straight, everything is straight, my arms are forward. And then I'm gonna twist. Twist, 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 twist as far as you can. And then back to center. Other side, pull, 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 pull. Back to center. And this time I'm gonna go circle my arms with the straps. So keep pulling. Keep pulling and do a circle one way and the other side. Very good. Okay, very good. And then bring it up. And then bring move your arms out so more there's more length between your arms. More space between your arms. So it's a little bit wider. And keep pulling. Keep pulling as much as you can. And then bring it to one side. And back to center. Other side. Bend, 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 and pull it down. Very good. And then bring it forward. And then go as far as you can. Twist. Center. Twist as far as you can. One more time. Twist as far as you can. Center. Pull. Center. Now bring it up. Okay. And we're going to do, number eight. So we're going to go one, two, three, four, and up. So figure eight. Do a figure eight with your arms. And the other arm comes on top. See if you can manage that. Very good. And remember which arm came on top. I forgot. Very good. And keep going. Very good. And the other arm goes up. And the other arm goes up. All right, good, good. I see you all moving around. Okay, one more time. Bend. Up. And then down, and bring it back to your thighs, and shake it out, and your arms, relax your arms. Very good. We're gonna do our legs now. Okay, so let's take one foot, under the one foot, and you sit at the edge of the chair, okay? Very soft bit. All right, now pulling with your arms and pushing with your legs. So you're gonna sit with your back straight and just pull, pull and let it go. While my foot is on the ground, pull up. I know if you don't have resistance band, then you just pull with your strap. Use the strength of your arms and down. One more time, up and down. Now this time, I'm still at the edge of the chair. I'm gonna move my leg up, foot up. So I'm pushing with my foot, pulling with my arms. Okay, push and pull, going at the same time. And bring your knee up as much as you can and out. And up and out. Up and out. Very good, last one. Up and out. Now let go of one arm. Same arm and same foot holding. The foot that's up, that's the same arm that's holding the strap now. Still at the edge of the chair. Pulling and pushing going on. Back is straight. And stay there. My this foot is straight. straight, all of it is on the ground, my foot is on the ground, knee over ankle. Alright? Free arm goes out, look at your arm, and now pull your leg on the opposite direction as far as it can go. 3-point move, very good. Inhale, exhale, hold the pose, breathe, but hold the pose. Back straight, tummy tight, and then bring it back to center. Exchange your arms, so it's opposite arms holding onto the strap now. The free arm is the other one. Look at your foot, look at your arm, and pull your foot across as far as you can. You won't go very far because this leg is in the way. But hold the pose, breathe through it, and come back center, and then bring it down. Very good. All right, let's do the other foot. Other foot, again, you're gonna pull and push. So pulling with your arms, pushing with the leg, hold on tight, yeah? And then bring it up. And when you're doing this, don't lock your knee, okay? Never lock your knee in any of your movements. If I forget to tell you, don't lock your knee. Soft is good. And just a little bit of movement like that. All right, and now I'm gonna let go of one arm. The arm that's holding the strap is the one that the foot is up. Okay? Nice and tight. Okay, this foot is on the ground. Straight. Free arm. What we did on the other side, we're going to do the same thing now. Hold tight. Bring your arm over. Look at your arm. Keep looking at your arm. And then move your leg to the other side. Inhale, exhale, breathe. Hold the pose. Breathe and hold the pose. Very good. And then come back center. Exchange your arm. Pulling, pushing going on all the time. Free arm goes out. Look at your arm. Bring your foot over. Won't go very far. And hold the pose. Breathe. And then come back center. Bring it up and down. Very good. Let's do this two legs, two arms. A little bit of give your back a break. So pull with your two arms and push with your legs and just move your both your legs up and hold that pose and see if you can bring both your knees up and down without touching the floor. While I'm pulling, it's like a swing movement. Very good. Also your knees are also moving here. Very good. And then bring it down and let go of your straps. Let's grab weights. Remember, if you haven't done weights in a while, be careful. If it's too much for you, lower your weight. If it's too easy, then you can go one step higher, okay? All right, let's sit at the edge of the chair. The weights are on my thighs, both on my thighs, okay? Back is straight, foot is flat on the ground, okay? And I lift one leg up. Hold it there, breathe. Remember to breathe. Just hold it so you can feel the weight on your leg. Okay, so using your legs for your holding the weight. And your tummy tight, smile, and bring it down. Other side, bring it up. Hold it there, hold it, breathe through it. Don't hold your breath. Breath, keep breathing. Nice and deep. And then bring it down. Let's do one, up, and down. The other one, up, and down. One more time, up. Down, up, and down. Now we're gonna just weights stay where they are. I'm just gonna move my foot out onto the side while the weight is on the ground and go down and then back again. So there is another muscles that are moving now with the weight. So using the weights in other areas of your body as well as the legs. And there and down. One more time with the other side. One, make sure you're breathing, smiling, and you're trying to keep your back straight. Last one, very good. And just adjust your chair again. This time when you're bringing it up, and then you go out, up, out, up, and out, while the weight is on your thigh. Excellent. Bring it down, bring it up to the other side. Up and out, up and out, up and out, last one, up and out, and then bring it down. Now slide 1 foot forward, okay? Come to the edge of the chair, the foot that's forward, the opposite weight goes on top of that weight. So my 1 foot is forward, so I've doubled my weight on my thigh. Not on your knees. This foot is nice and it's still steady on the ground, flat. So I've doubled weight, my foot is slided forward, not totally forward, just a little bit. And now, while I'm holding onto the weight, I'm going to lift up. So you've doubled your weight, okay, just using some muscles of your body with a little bit higher weight, double weight actually. One more, last one, very good. And then bring your leg back, and that's to the other side. So you bring the weight one side, then slide your foot, not too far, just a little bit. Bring the other weight down on top, hold on to the weight with both your hands. Okay, make sure you don't get hurt if it falls or something. And then just move up. One, two, three, four, five. Very good. Because we do a lot of sitting things, and then sometimes the legs need to be engaged. We do that when we get up too, but just so that the weights are used on your legs at the same time. That's what it was all about. All right? Okay, edge of the chair, bring your weights together. Bring your upper arms together. They're like sticking to your upper body. Upper arms are near your body. And you just open and shut. Open. Let's do 10 of those. Breathe. Look side to side. Smile. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, last one, 10, and bring it back to center, and bring your back, the weights back to your thigh. One goes down, arms are facing forward, palms are facing forward. Bring the other one down too, onto the side. You're just gonna lift up one, and then the other two. Three, smile, move your neck. Four, breathe. Five, six, seven, eight, nine, and last one, 10. Very good. Bring it to the side. Now we're going to go lift up side by side. So again, adjust, make sure you're sitting proper, back is straight, and you're just going to lift up. So when you lift up, make sure you're not going past your shoulder, okay? Whatever you can, not. If you're having a very heavy weight, be very careful. One, side by side, look side by side. Three, breathe, four, tummy tight, five, smile, six, seven, eight, nine, and last one, 10. Very good. And just let your arm go down, feel the pressure down, and up again, other side, let it go, and let the weight take you down, let the weight take you down. And up again, last one, very good. All right, now bring your weight to your shoulder, and you're gonna pull it up, okay? Remember, move your necks and breathe and smile. One, two, three, four, five, six, 7, 8, 9, and last one, 10. Bring it down, back to your thighs, bring your shoulders up, inhale, exhale, inhale again, exhale. Now just move your 1 foot a little bit forward, come to the edge of the chair, slide your 1 foot forward, and bring your arms down, okay? And we're just gonna bend a little bit, bring your chest forward, chin forward, back straight, okay? And now we're gonna go for a walk. One, two, three, four, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and last one, 10. Very good. Now bring both your feet a little forward. Both your feet forward, and also you move your chest forward, chin forward, back straight. Bring your weights to the side, and we're going to go back. So let's do one at a time, it's easier. So bring your weights down, and then you go 1, 2, bring it to the back. 3, you can look back if you like. 4, 5, you're swinging it to the back. 6, 7, 8, 9, and last one, 10. Let's do the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and last one, 10. Very good. Now bring your your feet are on the ground, both of them, knees over ankle. Go forward, bring your waist down and just pick up. 1, and look up and down. 2, 3, 4, 5, like you're picking up groceries. 6, 7, 8, 9, last one, 10. All right, let go of one weight. Bring one weight up, as far up as you can take it. And go behind your head. With your free arm, push your elbow back. We're just going to do lift ups behind your head. But keep holding on to your elbow if your weight is, you're not steady. All right, 3, 4, slowly, don't hit your head. Hold on, 5, if you're unsteady. 6, and look at up and down. 7, 8, 9, and last one, 10. Bring it down. Let's take the other arm up. Inhale, exhale, bring your arms back a little bit. Use your free arm to push your elbow back. And now you're gonna go up and down and use your head. Move your head up and down. 2, hold on if it's not steady. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and last one, 10. Very good, bring it down. Bring the weight, hold your weight with your two thighs, okay? Hold on with your two arms, first you're holding on, bring it down, and press your legs together. Press your legs together towards the weight. Hold your tummy tight, press, and then let go. Press, and let go. Press, very good, and let go. Very good, and then let's let go, okay? All right, let's do some cat and cow so that we can relax all our lower back and everything. So hold on to your knees, back straight, you're sitting at the edge. Let's inhale, you bring yourself forward, chest forward, shoulders go back, chin forward, look forward. Inhale, like you have to form a little concave with your back. Inhale, exhale, round your shoulder, chin to chest. Inhale, exhale. Inhale again, exhale, and let's do a circle. A lot of back movements today, and lower back, and last one, other way. Very good, very good, and stay steady, and then shake it up. Very good. All right, let's see where we are. All right, we're gonna stand up now, okay? So down. Okay, come to the edge of the chair, hands down. We're gonna, my feet are flat on the ground. Inhale, and I'm gonna get up. So totally get up, inhale. Arms up, and bring it to the side, bring it down. Bring it, move your legs out apart a bit, okay? So we're gonna cross our arms, and we're gonna bend. Inhale, up, exhale. Opposite arm on the front, inhale, Exhale, inhale, opposite arm in the front. One more time, inhale, exhale, and bring your arms up, palms together, nice and steady. Feet, you can keep your feet right together to make a straight line, or you can leave it a little bit apart, whatever you want to do. Inhale, exhale, slowly down, exhale, exhale, exhale. Press your palms towards each other. Let's do push, one side, totally over, and then back to center. Push, push, push. Do a full twist as much as you can. Twist. Very good. And center. Other side. Center. And then let go. Okay? Bring your arms down. Feet are, toes are pointing forward. Bring your arms on the side. Inhale up. And let's see if you can do a little bit of a sway. And center. Other side. Very good. One more time. Center, other side. Very good. And bring your arms down. And then do a squat. So separate your legs, toes pointing a little bit outwards. And we're just gonna do the bend with your back, with your butt. So the butt is gonna go down. I'm not going down like this. It's my butt that's going down. See the difference? If I go down myself, like down, it'll be like this. But I want to move my butt down. But make sure you can see your toes, okay? Don't go past your toes. That's not good. So bring your arms out. Bring your arms up. Look forward. And then just try and leave your back straight as much as possible. And just move your back butt down as far as you can go. One, two, three, four, five. Very good, and bring it down. So at least five squats, okay? And now let's march, 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 march. Go forward, go back, and let's go behind our chair. Go behind your chair. Make sure there's room to move around. Hold on to your chair. Let's go on your toes up. Look forward and down. One more time, look up, up, up on your toes, and down on your, flat on your feet. Up on your toes, and then now on your heels. Feel, go on your heels and your toes. So you're rocking on your base of your foot. Feet are very important too. Make sure you are also using all the movements in your feet too. Very good. Now stay on your, I'm gonna turn so you can see me. I'm on my toes, okay? But I'm holding on to the chair. Both arms or together or one arm, whatever works for you. One arm I'm holding. Right now, I'm on my toes, balance. This is the other part of our aging process that we need to get stronger on to avoid any falls, okay? Okay, so I'm on my toes, I'm holding on. Now I'm gonna let go if I want to. One arm, two arms, whatever works for you, and steady. Stay on your toes and look forward. Gaze is soft, breathe softly. Hang on to it, hang on to your, steady on your toes as much, as long as you can. You may feel a little wobbly if you haven't done this for a while. But make sure you're doing it so you're remaining, even with holding is okay. Alright? And then slowly come down. Very good, and shake it up, shake it up. Okay, again, you can do this way, but I'm going to show you this way. So, or I can even do this way, holding onto my chair. I'm going to lift my leg up maybe 6 inches, okay, and I'm going to look forward, and I'm going to hang on to the chair with two arms, okay, whatever works for you. And if I want to let go, I let go one arm, doesn't matter which arm, this one or that one, or I can let go both arms, and I'm just balancing on my one foot, looking forward, soft gaze, soft gaze. Inhale, exhale. Very good. And steady, steady. And then bring it down. Very good. And shake it up, shake it out. Let's do the other foot. Again, doesn't have to be very high. Just 6 inches is okay. All right, hold on. Okay, look forward. Both arms are holding. My knees up. Foot is up. I can hold on to one or two. Doesn't matter. Okay. And you can balance for a few minutes, few seconds even. If you're wobbly, just touch the chair. This should be every day. Like if you practice more, the more longer you'll be able to stand. Remember not to gaze hard, just soft gaze forward. Take a point, pick a point, and then just hang in there. Very good. Breathe, and then bring your foot down, and then shake it out. Shake it out, hold onto the chair, and then come close to the chair, and then slide one foot back as far as you can, as far as you can. Okay, once it's the farthest and you're stretched, you're holding onto the chair, I will bend my front knee, but I don't want to go past my ankle. I have to see my toes, okay? So your toes have to be visible. Don't go too far like that. That's very bad for your knees. So just go on top of your ankle. Now, I'll go on my back foot, I'll go on my toe, and down. Just rock on your back foot and adjust if it's too close. Up and down. Again, you're stretching a lot of your muscles in your legs and your butt area too. Down and up and down. And then slowly slide forward. Let's do the same with the other foot. Slide back as far as you can. Okay? And then when I've done enough, spread out, I will just bend my knee. Feel that nice little pull in my calf area, and then I'll go up on my toes in the back and down, up and down, up and down, very good, and up, and then bring it back forward. Now, same chair again, I'm going to go back with one foot, and keep a little bit of distance now between the chair, maybe about a foot, okay, and then go back a little bit, and then lift up your leg. Lift up the leg, not too high, just a little bit is good. Opposite arm goes out, forward. Okay? So like that. Again, you can stay here. Stay here. Make sure you don't lock your knee, okay? Stay there. One arm is good enough. Or you can let go, look forward, and stay there for a few seconds. If you're wobbly, you touch your foot back on the ground. Look forward. Very good. And then you come back down like that. Okay? Let's do the other foot. Slide slowly back. And then just lift it up 6 inches, whatever works for you. Not too high. Little bit. When you're steady, other arm goes out. Okay? And just stay there like that. If you feel comfortable, you want to let go of your other arm and look forward. Breathe, focus. If you're wobbly, just touch the floor or the chair. Only do what you can, and then bring it back here, center. Very good. Hold on to the chair. Spread your feet out a bit, and let's go down. Squatting, but you're holding the chair this time. Hold the chair, and then go down. One, two, three, four, and last one, five. Very good. And then bring it back to the center. Whew, time is going fast. Okay, moving to the side. And let's do a bit of Jerusalem. I don't know if you remember the steps, but don't worry about the steps. We don't have time to teach you guys. But let's do the dance movements now. Step, step, four steps.
Oh, no, 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 no,
It was four taps, step taps, and then we did this for the, I think, Kushali, for New Year's Kushali, Kushali program. Anyway, let's do this one. So have a seat, have a drink of water, and then you're gonna calm down a little bit. Just feel comfortable. And I'm just gonna play a little bit of this, and then you're gonna go into meditation, okay? The meditation is feeling safe in turbulent times. But this one I'm gonna play for maybe a few seconds is called Dil Se Dua, right? It's really nice. Hands to heart, just enjoy. Get yourself inside yourselves, okay? Feel that moment. Anyway, we come to the end of the yoga. So I want you to sit comfortable down on the floor, wherever you are comfortable, and take this few minutes to yourself. It's a really good meditation, and it's about turbulent times that we're going through, uncertainty, hopes, fears, challenges, all sorts of things, right? So let's close your eyes, breathe normal, be in any position you feel comfortable. Enjoy.
We are living in times that can sometimes be turbulent, both on a personal level and a global level. What do I need to do to keep my peace in turbulent times? One of the things that is essential for this is solitude. Let me go within right now and center myself in stillness, becoming as peaceful as the evening sky. And in this moment, let me just become aware of the mystery and intelligence of the universe. Sometimes it's tempting to try to fix everyone around me and to try to fix all the problems on the planet. But I will lose my peace that way because it's an impossible task. I can only fix my own mind and give as much as I can to those around me. To keep my peace, in addition to solitude, I need to trust in the intelligence of the universe. Just like the tree whose roots go deep beneath the surface, in the same way, the significance of situations, the wisdom behind situations, like those roots, is not always visible. I may not like the path or direction that situations are heading in, but let me trust that there is something operating beneath the surface that is unseen to the physical eyes. And that destination might be very benevolent. Some of the greatest pains have turned into the greatest gifts. Some of the most wounded people have become the greatest healers and teachers. So instead of labeling things as good or bad, instead of resisting the turbulence around me, let me trust in its destination. Let me trust in the wisdom of it and stay peaceful. Seasons are a part of life. Winter, darkness are an inevitable part of life. But there has never been a winter and there has never been a night that hasn't given way to spring. In the same way, peace can come when I trust that this dark passage will pass. Peace will come when I go into solitude and become aware of the mystery and intelligence of this wonderful world. I have one business, and if I can remember this business, peace will become easier. My business is to go within, to touch my own light, and to radiate the qualities of my soul into the world. My business is to illuminate the darkness of my mind and make it springtime once more in my inner landscape. And once I do this, the next thing that I have to focus on is giving. That is the other part of my business What can I give to the world each day? How can I give in as many moments as possible to as many people as possible? If I want to keep my peace in turbulent times, I have to know that with solitude and wisdom and trust, I can pass through these tunnels of turbulence and move through doorways that lead to places of greater wisdom, strength, and illumination.
With that, open your eyes, bring your hands to heart. Inhale, up, 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 as far up as you can go. And exhale, slowly down, 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 down. Let go of everything. Inhale, up, bring the energy back into your lives, into your minds, into your souls. Thank you, Yali Madad, and Namaste.